Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Morning. Today we celebrate the fourth Sunday in Lent, and so let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so by following your holy will we may gain eternal salvation. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the first form of the Confiteor found on page 66. Almighty Father, you know my deepest secrets. I confess that I have, through my own fault, sinned against your holy laws in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done or failed to do. I sincerely regret my sins, and I am truly sorry for offending you. I ask, Father, that in your mercy you pardon my sins. I promise to change my way of living so that through deeper holiness I may better serve you throughout the rest of my life. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say two Hail Marys. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lead out the people who are blind, though they have eyes, who are deaf, though they have ears. Let all the nations gather together. Let the peoples assemble. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, enlighten our minds with your unchanging truth, always believing in the Son of God. May we be led in the ways of salvation. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading is from the first book of Samuel. The Lord said to Samuel, "Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I am sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem, for I have chosen my king from among his sons." As Jesse and his sons came to the sacrifice, Samuel looked at Eliab and thought, "Surely the Lord's anointed is here before him." But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not judge from his appearance or from his lofty stature, because I have rejected him. Not as man sees does God see, because man sees the appearance, but the Lord looks into the heart. In the same way, Jesse presented 7 sons before Samuel, but Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any one of these." Then Samuel asked Jesse, "Are these all the sons you have?" Jesse replied, "There is still the youngest, who is tending the sheep." Samuel said to Jesse, "Send for him. We will not begin the sacrificial banquet until he arrives here." Jesse sent and had the young man brought to them. He was ruddy, a youth handsome to behold, and making a splendid appearance. The Lord said, "There, anoint him, for this is the one." Then Samuel, with the horn of oil in his hand, anointed David in the presence of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon David. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want."
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Besides restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, we were once darkness, but now you are the light of the Lord. Live as the children of light. And for light produces every kind of goodness and righteousness and truth. Try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord. Take no part in fruitless works of darkness. Rather expose them, for it is shameful even to mention the things done by them in secret. But everything exposed by light becomes visible, for everything that becomes visible is light. Therefore it says, "Awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life. Praise to you, Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. As Jesus passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "Neither he nor his parents sinned. It is so that the works of God might be made visible through him. We have to do the works of the one who sent me while it is day. Night is coming when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world." When he had said this, he spat on the ground and made clay with the saliva, and smeared the clay on his eyes, and said to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. So he went and washed and came back able to see. His neighbors and those who had seen him earlier as a beggar said, "Isn't this the one who used to sit and beg?" Some said, "It is." But others said, "No, he just looks like him." He said, "I am." So they said to him, "How were your eyes opened?" He replied, "The man called Jesus made clay and anointed my eyes and told me, 'Go to Siloam and wash.' So I went there and washed and was able to see." And they said to him, "Where is he?" He said, "I don't know." They brought the one who was once blind to the Pharisees. Now Jesus had made clay and opened his eyes on a Sabbath. So then the Pharisees also asked him how he was able to see. He said to them, "He put clay on my eyes, and I washed, and now I can see." Some of the Pharisees said, "This man is not from God, because he does not keep the Sabbath." But others said, "How can a sinful man do such signs?" And there was a division among them. So they said to the blind man again, "What do you have to say about him, since he opened your eyes?" He said, "He is a prophet." Now the Jews did not believe that he had been blind and gained his sight, until they summoned the parents of the one who had gained his sight. They asked him, "Is this your son who you say was born blind? How does he now see?" His parents answered and said, "We know that this is our son and that he was born blind. We do not know how he sees now, nor do we know who opened his eyes. Ask him, he is of age, he can speak for himself." His parents said this because they were afraid of the Jews, for the Jews had already agreed that if anyone acknowledged him as the Christ, they would be expelled from the synagogue. For this reason, the parents said, "He is of age, question him." So a second time they called the man who had been blind and said to him, "Give God the praise. We know that this man is a sinner." He replied, "If he is a sinner, I do not know. One thing I do know is that I was blind, and now I see." So they said to him, "What did he do to you? How did he open your eyes?" He answered them, "I told you already, and you did not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? Do you want to become his disciples too?" They ridiculed him and said, "You are that man's disciple. We are disciples of Moses. We know that God spoke to Moses, but we do not know where this one is from." The man answered and said to them, "This is what is so amazing, that you do not know where he is from, yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not listen to sinners, but if one is devout and does his will, he listens to him. It is unheard of that anyone ever opened the eyes of a person born blind. If this man were not from God, he would not be able to do anything." They answered and said to him, "You were born totally in sin, and you are trying to teach us?" Then they threw him out. When Jesus heard that they had thrown him out, he found him and said, "Do you believe in the Son of Man?" He answered and said, "Who is he, sir, that I may believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have seen him, and the one speaking with you is he." He said, "I do believe, Lord." And he worshiped him. Then Jesus said, "I came into this world for judgment, so that those who do not see might see, and those who do see might become blind." Some of the Pharisees who were with him heard this and said to him, "Surely we are not also blind, are we?" Jesus said to them, "If you were blind, you would have no sin. But now you are saying, 'We see.' So your sin remains." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
If you were blind, you would have no sin, but now you are saying we see, so your sin remains. So it's taken from today's gospel according to St. John, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today was a rather long gospel, I think we can all agree, but it tells a very interesting and in-depth story. It's about blindness and sight. And while Jesus is healing physical blindness in this man, and he did it on a Sabbath, which the Pharisees are trying to trap him, so we know that we're getting closer and closer to the crucifixion, the idea of blindness and sight is also one of a spiritual nature. Because we, because of our fallen heritage, have a tendency to fall into sin. We have a blindness that we have. And Jesus came to give us that sight. And through his words that have been passed down from the apostles, through the successors of the apostles to today, we can gain that sight. Now, Jesus' words to the Pharisees at the end is also very telling, because if you were blind, you would have no sin, but now you are saying we see, so your sin remains. If we are blind and we do not know that which is going to lead us to heaven through no fault of our own, then of course we would have no sin because we had no way of knowing. But if we do know and then reject it, that's on us. Now, any deacon, priest, bishop, their job is to bring those people who are in their charge, as far as they can, to heaven. That's my job. That's Bishop Jerry's job. It's all the priests in our church's job. And here's the rub. If we don't do that in our time here on earth, when we go to heaven, we have to answer for that in front of Christ himself. He's going to ask, did you do all you could to bring home all the people that I put in front of you? Now, once we do our job, then it's up to you, just like it was with the Pharisees and Jesus. But also to those of us who have received the gospel and accept it and know the teachings, we are also have that obligation to put those, take those in our charge and help them get to heaven. So that is then on those of us who have received the truth to spread it around and give others the opportunity. So during this Lent, perhaps we can reflect on those ways that we have those opportunities to help others get to heaven. And look at those ways maybe in the past that we have not taken advantage of those opportunities, and maybe be more prepared for when those opportunities do arise, so that when Jesus asks us, what did you do to bring the people I put in front of you back home? The answer will be good instead of bad. If you were blind, you would have no sin, but now you are saying we see, so your sin remains. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, with the Father and the Son. He is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. As we continue our Lenten journey, let us not grow weary of asking the Lord for all of our needs. Our response is, Lord, have mercy.
For the Church, that she may remain a steadfast symbol of God's light and unfailing love for in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For public officials, that they may be good stewards of the authority entrusted to them and use it for the common good and follow Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For each of us here, that we may renew and deepen our efforts at genuine repentance offered to us in the sacrament of reconciliation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick, especially those on the parish prayer list, that they may trust in God's continuing love for them and experience his healing touch, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. And for Dr. Julio Ramos, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the beloved deceased and those who will die today, that they may live in the light of God's presence forever, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Loving Father, grant as we bring our needs before you, we may see your Son more clearly and receive his gifts of holiness. We ask this, both spoken and unspoken, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Everyone who is named as mine, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made, lead out the people who are blind, though they have eyes, who are deaf, though they have ears. Creation through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth is given, and human hands have made. May it become for us the bread of life. Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. May it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless the sacrifice which we have prepared for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, May they whose memory we honor on earth intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord our God, you call us from darkness into light through the passion and merits of your Son. May this offering strengthen us when we are tested. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through our fasting, you increase divine life within us. You preserve us from sin and lead us into eternal life. Through our abstinence, you confirm us in goodness and curb our unbridled vices. As we commemorate this 40-day fast of your Son, may we, together with him, give you glory. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy sacrifice of the Mass will continue with Eucharistic Prayer 4, which is found on page 88. Blessed are you, Lord of all majesty and King of eternal glory, through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. In him your word was made flesh. In him the fullness of your grace was revealed in splendor. In all things he fulfilled your will and glorified your name. He proclaimed your kingdom to us. He broke the power of darkness over us. He took our guilt upon himself. He reconciled us to you and unlocked the new paradise for us. As the way, the truth, and the life, he has revealed your love to us. He humbled himself and became obedient even to death on a cross, and by rising restored our life. On the night in which he was betrayed to undergo that suffering which he himself had chosen, he took bread into his hands, lifted his eyes to you, his heavenly Father, he gave thanks. He blessed the bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you. Supper had ended, he took the cup and gave thanks to you, blessed it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me. Together, your death, Lord Jesus, we proclaim, your resurrection we celebrate, your return in glory we await. Therefore, Father, we remember his saving passion, his glorious resurrection, his exaltation at your right hand. We await his coming in the fullness of majesty. We here set forth this sign of our faith in him who offered you the perfect sacrifice and gained for us eternal salvation. Send your Holy Spirit, the giver of life and holiness, upon us, and upon these gifts, the bread and wine of eternal life. Together, Holy Spirit, come to us. Fill us with your gift of grace. Take these gifts from our hands, Lord God, as an acceptable sacrifice, through which we offer ourselves to you, so that the bread which we break and the cup which we bless may be a sharing in the body and blood of your Son. May all who receive from your heavenly altar always remain united with you, together with all your saints and chosen ones, with the blessed and glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of our Lord, with St. Joseph, whose memory we keep today, with your prophets and apostles, with your martyrs and confessors, and with all who stand about your throne in praise and prayer. Grant also, Lord, a share in that glory to the departed and to those whom we remember before you, especially Dr. Ramos, for whom this Mass is being offered. Deal with them and with all people according to your merciful kindness, and let perpetual light shine upon them. Remember also your servants on earth for whom we invoke your mercy, especially all those who were praying with us today. Bless your church throughout the world. Grant it unity and peace. Renew the earth according to your promise. Remember all peoples and grant that all nations may give you thanks, worshiping and praising your holy name. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Page 95, let us pray together with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Let's say together the First Communion prayer found on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching and never let me be parted from you. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. Those who are joining us online or for whom personal reasons cannot receive the body and blood of Christ today, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. Behold, this is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. God and the blood of Christ.
Amen.
Body and 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 blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ.
Amen.
Body and blood of Christ.
Amen.
The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ.
Thank you.
May God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. And may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ.
Lord, what were you saying? I must have fallen asleep. Could have sworn I heard you talking. Or maybe it was just a dream. It sounded something like redemption, an echo from a younger day. Lord, how long have I been drifting? My tears are falling as I pray. Lord, wake up the sleeper. I lift my head, I lift my head. Your searchlight's found me here at my
at my end.
much madness all around. They wear their darkness on their sleeves. But now my blinded eyes are open, and I see the darkest part of me. Lord, wake up the sleeper.
Came into the world as light so that everyone who believes in me might not remain in darkness. Let us pray. Almighty God, your Son endured the loneliness and darkness of the cross to gain for us eternal life with you. We thank you that in this Eucharist we experience the light of your countenance and know that we are never abandoned. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me so love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light, and where there is sadness, joy, O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for Holy Mass today. We pray that you have a wonderful day, a wonderful week. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other, remain in a state of grace, fight evil wherever you find it, and spread joy wherever you go.